Kenyans are suffering in Saudi Arabia. I've been looking at these stories that have been coming from NTV, from Tuko, from Lynn Gugi, and they are some of the most disheartening stories that you'll ever hear.
Mahara, please. Saizi, siwezi advise mtu akuje hapa Saudi. Juu Saudi si mali kuzuri, wacha tu ni kuambie. Au watu daka mbili ni wazuri, daka mbili ni mashetani yani.
Nimechapwa, nilichapwa asubuhi, nimetoroka nimeenda polisi, nimerudishwa kwa hii nyumba, nimetandikwa tena.
For most the story is the same. Maisha ilikuwa ngumu Kenya, mtu akafika mwisho and then they saw that the only way out is to go to Saudi or go to Qatar to find greener pastures. But then the people who took them there, they go there and dump them, they have no help, and then they are mistreated, some are even burnt, some are beaten, and some even end up dead. But then we have zero support structure for people who go there to allow them to have good working conditions or even to have them come back. Mtu amejitoa huku, amelipia pesa ya passport, wengine hata huo ananyaganywa hizo pesa. Mtu unalipia passport na mwenye ulipia the agent, mwenye ulikuwa una deal na yeye anatupotea na pesa yako. And you have suffered a lot already in Kenya. Hiyo process ya kuenda si rahisi because you need to put in your own money, ununua passport, may get the necessary documents. Sometimes ni wewe unajilipia flight even though a lot of agents ndio wanakulipia flight. And then unafika huko, the first person that you are given ni mtu mwenye, they don't care about your human health, they don't care about your humanity at all. Na zori zingine unasikia that the kind of houses that these people are maintaining, big enough to be called stadiums. Mtu ni yeye housemate, mtu ni yeye anaosha watoto, mtu ni yeye anatake care of watoto, mtu ni yeye anapikia the people in the house, their mother-in-laws, their father-in-laws, and all their relatives. And the match wanalipo ni around 800 to 900 shillings per day, which comes to around 20-something K per month. So it's not a lot of money. Add on to that the suffering. If you make any mistake, you are beaten, you are slapped, wengine wanachomwa na majimoto, wengine wanachomwa na pasi. Those are some very devastating conditions. And then to make it worse, if you try to get out, the police are on the side of those bosses. So you have poor working conditions, you can't run away. Your health, if you get sick, now that's your problem because they can't treat you. They tell you are there to work, not to get sick. Yeah, that's not good at all. And I don't understand why as Kenya we don't have a strong embassy in a place like that. Because you know you should be able to seek refuge to your own country's embassy. But then you hear the stories that are coming out of that place and you hear that the Kenyan embassy is not helping, the Kenyan agents there are not helping, the agents here are not helping. And then you hear about some other third world countries like the Philippines who have a good structure of exporting labor to places like those. Everything is government mandated. They are protected by the government, they are helped by the government. But for us here, mtu anajitegemea tu. So I don't know the solution to this issue honestly, but I think it deserves more attention. People need to hear this. I hope the people who are in power, people who can do something about it, are able to hear this. And I would like even to see some celebs highlighting these issues. So if you want to learn more, I'll leave some links in the description. Prepare yourself because there are some very disheartening stories. But hope you also get some good overview of what's happening in Saudi Arabia. And if there is anything you can do, you can also chip in.